For our Christmas card today, I've taken in kind of an inventory of the things that I had left from last year. Since it's really early in the season, it's only in the middle of summer, and a lot of the new Christmas things aren't out yet, I'm taking a look at what I already had, and I found some designer paper that I got in really late last Christmas, too late to use for any cards, with some snowflakes on it, and I'm cutting this to 4 inches wide by 5.5. I also had some stamp sets. This was a new stamp set that's still available from Stamping Up called For the Holidays. I haven't even mounted all of it. I'm going to use the Peace on Earth stamp from that. And then another stamp set that is still available from Stamping Up, Serene Snowflakes. We're going to make use of that set as well and some of our different inks. One of the things I liked about working with this paper is its non-traditional Christmas colors, with some blues and greens and all, some sort of ease into the holiday season. There's more information on my blog about getting an early start on your Christmas cards and some ideas for those. So let's get started with this one. Again, I have the designer paper cut to 4 by 5.5, and I have a piece of white vellum that I've cut to, I think it's 3.5 inches wide. I've actually torn the edges. I used a scoring blade to mark them and then tear them, so I got a little bit of a rough edge, but not too rough of an edge. And I went ahead and left it a full 6 inches long because I'm going to use that to fold over the back. One other preparation that I've made for the card is to go ahead and stamp Peace on Earth on the vellum using some fluid chalk ink. We're going to be doing some embossing, and fluid chalk ink that normally dries immediately on regular paper takes a while to dry on your vellum, so you can emboss it. So I wanted to go ahead and make sure this was dry. I dried it with a heat gun, and it's all ready to go. So now I can add some snowflakes. I'm using Whisper White craft ink from Stampin' Up, and I'm going to use my fluid chalk ink from Colorbox. I'm also using some iridescent ice, which is Stampin' Up's glittery embossing powder, to do my embossing. With craft ink or pigment inks, they also stay wet for quite a while on any kind of paper, and definitely on vellum. So I'll have a moment to get this embossed. Just randomly putting a few snowflakes on. Sprinkle my iridescent ice on there really good. Okay, now that I've had a chance to use the heat gun to melt the embossing powder, you can see that the iridescent ice has given us a nice sparkle, including this blue, this was Prussian blue, Colorbox chalk ink as well. Now, one ink that dries really fast, even on vellum, is the classic or dye ink from Stampin' Up. And I'm going to use some of that and some Bermuda Bay. And I just picked my colors based on what looked good with my designer paper. Add a little bit of this to the background of my card. Okay. Now, then my card is ready to start assembling. And you'll see how the snowflakes are going to create a double layer over the with the snowflake pattern from the designer paper underneath, and then the snowflakes on top with the vellum. And I left this area, I didn't worry too much about this area right here because there's going to be some ribbon going over that. Now, the reason that I left the vellum a little bit longer is I need a way to attach this vellum to the card. So what I'm doing is lining up the bottom edge of the vellum and the designer paper, and then just folding the vellum over the top. Of the designer paper. And I can go ahead and even add a little bit of adhesive now. Get that ready to go. And it's about ready to go on the card. Next step is to add our ribbons. Before I do though, I think I'm going to add a couple of glue dots just to hold this vellum in place. I want sort of a loose look, so I don't want a lot of glue dots there, but just a couple of small ones underneath where the ribbon is going to be placed. I think we'll anchor everything down. And then I'll attach my ribbon. Also with some glue dots. I'm using some of the larger memory book glue dots. Oops. Set that up. Okay. And then we'll add one more piece of ribbon. And our card is almost complete. It's ready to glue to the card front. You may notice as I've worked a little bit of this Bermuda Bay dye ink rubbed off, but it's mostly, it dries pretty fast. It's not, it doesn't dry instantly on vellum, but it dries pretty fast. It's not wet enough to emboss, but just be careful. You might get a little bit of it on your fingers, but it still dries pretty quickly. And there you have a Christmas card already done. Just a piece of vellum, a few stamps, and a little ribbon, and you can have a few already tucked away and be on top of things for the holidays. Thank you for joining me today, and next week we'll do another Christmas card or holiday card.